Mr. President, on behalf of President Carter and the people of the United States, we welcome you again to the United States with a warm heart. The people of our country admire greatly your wisdom, your courage, and your statesmanship. Welcome to the United States.
Well, Mr. Vice President, Mr. Vance, thank you for your thoughtful words and the genuine sentiments you expressed towards me and the Egyptian people. As you well know, these feelings are mutual. The Egyptian people value very highly the ever-growing friendship and cooperation with the people and leadership of the United States. We are also gratified by the keen interest you are maintaining in the establishment of a comprehensive, just, and lasting peace in the Middle East. All along, we have held the view that this nation is the most qualified to be a full partner in the peace process. Your heritage is unique, and so is your global responsibility. When you demonstrated your determination to assume such responsibility fully, you reaffirmed the faith of my people in the United States and its dedication to the cause of peace. We come here at a crucial crossroad. The challenge is tremendous, but we have no choice except to accept the challenge. We cannot afford to fail the hopes of nations all over the world. No one has the right to block the road to peace. This is no time for maneuvers and worn out ideas. It is time for magnanimity and reason. I pray to God Almighty to guide us in this great endeavor and enable us to achieve the noble goal which inspired President Carter to call for this conference. This inspiration is and shall remain a brave and gallant act of statesmanship. Together, we shall proceed to build a viable structure for peace on the solid foundation of law and legitimacy. Together, we shall realize the hopes of those who believe in the supremacy of right and justice, and together we shall overcome. Thank you.
That's a good American line, we shall overcome. Welcome. And delighted, I guess. Yes,
Oh!
Mr. Prime Minister, on behalf of President Carter and the American people, we welcome you warmly to the United States. The American people deeply admire your leadership, its genius, its strength, its compassion. Above all, we admire your profound commitment to peace, so appropriate at this historic moment. Mr. Prime Minister, we welcome you with a warm heart.
Thank you.
Mr. Vice President, Mr. Secretary of State, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, 4 times I visited the President of the United States in the interests of peace since we were elected by our peoples to conduct their affairs, to care for the future, and for the preservation of liberty and democracy in our countries and elsewhere. 2 times I met the President of Egypt in a spirit of understanding, in goodwill, in common striving for peace in Jerusalem and in Ismailia. However, there is no doubt that this 5th meeting with President Carter and 3rd with President Sadat is the most important, the most momentous of them all. My friends and colleagues, the Foreign Minister, the Defense Minister, and I, and our friends and advisors, will make all endeavors possible to reach an agreement so that the peace process can continue and ultimately be crowned with peace treaties. This is the peace mission on behalf of which we come now to you, Mr. Vice President, to the United States, and to our dear friend, the President of the United States. We are grateful to the President for the hospitality he bestowed upon us in his retreat at Camp David. And let us all hope that out of that unique political conclave, a day will come when the nations of the world will say, Habemus Pacem, we have peace. Thank you.
Well, there you have it, Tom. And from Prime Minister Begin, what was really perhaps the most telling clue was